this morning in The Modern Parent. Daylight saving time is here, and thankfully that means longer days and, once spring officially arrives, more time outdoors. But how do we help children understand and handle the concept of setting the clocks forward? We visited with our friends at the Children's Workshop to learn more.
It's no secret that children are creatures of habit, and it's crucial to keep this in mind when planning their days.
They love their schedule, they love their routine, and even a difference in 60 minutes, that seems just like an hour to an adult, but that is really an eternity to a small child.
It's important to note that you can still keep the majority of their regularly scheduled activities intact to help them deal with the time change.
Eat dinner at the same time, do homework at the same time, snack is at the same time, still do your same nightly routine with bath and story time, but you might want to shift everything back just a few minutes every night so that everybody can transition into the new time change.
They react to light as well, so try to expose them to the sun since it will benefit their internal body clocks.
Some children are very sensitive to light. And, you know, if it's light out at a time of day where it's not typically light out, you want to make sure that they're exposed to light. When you do have a sunny day, spend some time outside. Really expose them to that light, because we don't realize how much sunlight can affect a child's functioning.
It can be very tough, but parents need to make sure that they get the appropriate amount of rest as well.
If at all possible, take a nap throughout the course of the day if you can. 20 minutes a day. We're all going to be getting used to being outside more. Make sure you're taking your vitamins, make sure you're taking care of yourself so that you're ready for spring and summer.
Though the transition may be difficult, in time the children will adjust.
Expect some unpredictable things to happen. So you might expect your child to wake up a little bit earlier in the morning, and you know, don't overreact to that. You know, you just have to kind of take it for what it is and have faith that everybody's schedules will get back on track.
Most importantly, use the time shift as a great learning opportunity.
You might want to read some books about telling time, and you might want to inform your child, you know, why do we set the clocks ahead in the spring and why do we fall back? And, you know, it's just a great little lesson to be able to teach.
Great advice, as always, from the experts at the Children's Workshop. We'll have more on this topic on our website. It's the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.